Good morning, everyone. Again, we wouldn't classify this as a major ice storm, but there is enough ice out there to cause some problems. It's mostly just drizzle right now, and the problem is the temperature is below freezing. So if you peek out the window, you see there's nothing going on. It's a little deceptive. That drizzle's been going on for 3 or 4 hours, and it has accumulated a small little bit of ice on just about everything, including the sidewalks and the side streets that haven't been treated, and your car. You'll have to scrape your windshield if you left it outside. Most of the heavier precipitation is missing us to the north, and that's good. And this is mostly snow from York up towards Harrisburg and then back over towards Hagerstown. And around Baltimore, there's nothing showing up on the radar. But we know that it's out there. We know that there is some drizzle, and we know that the ice has been accumulating. So be careful. Even though if you pull up the radar at home and you see most of the stuff off to the north of us, that is not the case. We do have some ice accumulating this morning. Let's switch it over. Take a look at the temperatures. Right now, we're below freezing, even in the southern suburbs. So it's going to take, I think, 5 or 6 hours to get the temperature above 32 degrees this morning. It's 29 at the airport, 28 in Annapolis, 26 in Parkton, mid-20s up near the Pennsylvania line. The problem is there's a big area of high pressure in New England that's kind of pushing the cold air down the coast. So we're not getting much of a push from the south here. So that's why it's going to take a while to warm up. You see the temperatures in the teens and single digits across New York State and back into New England. So with that kind of a setup, it's going to take a while for the temperature to get above freezing. So right now we have the little bit of ice going on here in the mid-Atlantic region. But the center of the storm is still way off to our southwest in the southern plains. It's just now getting organized. We're going to be on the quote-unquote warm side of this, but as it cuts up through Kentucky, Tennessee, and into Ohio later today, it's going to create blizzard conditions for the folks in the Midwest, Chicago, Milwaukee, Detroit, going to pick up close to 2 feet of snow with perhaps wind gusts over 60 miles per hour later on today and tonight. So we're not getting the worst of this storm by any means. But this morning, you still have to be careful. Freezing, light rain or drizzle, and then the temperature will get above freezing after lunchtime probably. The highs will be in the mid-30s. Driving around this afternoon, the roads are going to be just fine. A chance for rain showers tonight, and then late tonight, 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, the temperature could briefly drop below freezing again. So there could be a period of freezing rain early on Wednesday. But the good news is, as the center storm passes to our west on Wednesday, our surface winds will turn to the south. So if we dip below 32 early in the morning, it'll warm up quickly, and we'll make it into the 40s, I think, in the afternoon on Wednesday, with, again, the snow and the worst of the weather staying off to our west. So mostly just rain, I think, during the day on Wednesday with a brief period of freezing rain, perhaps between 3 and 6 a.m. The high temperature about 42 degrees. And then after that, it clears up. It's going to be breezy and chilly on Thursday, but dry with a high near 35. Friday should be dry as well. Going into the beginning of the weekend, another storm comes at us from the south, and I think it'll be a mix of all kinds of stuff again on Saturday. With a high temperature near 37, it should clear up on Sunday.